cosmetic products, whether they be hand soap, shampoo, toothpaste, whatever it may be. But do we really know where these products are coming from? Does anyone really read the label? Or is it about the smell, the appearance, or what the product claims it's going to do for you? If you really look at the fine print on these products, most products are tested on animals. Even popular ones like Crest, Aveeno, you will find out that a lot of them test on animals to make sure they're safe for humans. And I don't know about you, but I don't think a rat is very similar to a human, nor a bunny, or any lab-tested animal for that fact. In today's time, we need to stop testing products on these defenseless animals and find a better way to ensure the safety of these products for human use. Every day, people are using these products, but most have no idea where they come from. They just pick it up off the shelf and use it, without reading the fine print, without seeing where it's coming from. One of the biggest problems with this is we're continuing to support product testing on animals. If you're buying a product that's tested on animals, you're showing you don't really care that it's been tested on animals. According to PETA, there are many different experiments that are done on animals. One is called the Dre's Eye Experiment. They inject different products into the eyes and the skin, shaved skin of rabbits, and the test is conducted to see if any irritation occurs. And they watch these rabbits for weeks, and they don't give them any pain medicine, they give them nothing, and these animals are suffering for our benefit. And so there could be a different way to do this. These animals are being used every day, and according to the Animal Legal Defense Fund, over 100 million animals are exploited in different ways, such as military, automobiles, cosmetics, and different product testing. And over 95% of these animals aren't protected under law. According to the Animal Welfare Act, laboratories aren't legally required to disclose how many animals they are using for product testing, but it's estimated that over 1 million animals are used for product testing each year. The animals are being used to test products to test their safety, but this is not a requirement from the government. The Humane Society states it is legally required that cosmetics and other products be tested to prove their safety before it can be put up for sale, but nothing states that products must be tested on animals. The FDA is responsible for the assurance that all cosmetic products are properly labeled, but that products need to be tested for safety, but that does not require for it to be tested on animals. The Food and Drug Cosmetic Act also states that products need to be tested for safety, but do not require animal testing to assure safety. One of the main problems, not just the fact that animals are being used for product testing, but that these animals are being harmed, and even if the product passes animal testing, doesn't mean that it's going to be put on the shelf for human use. The MSPCA said, according to the Food and Drug Administration, 9 out of 10 pharmaceuticals that pass the Animal Testing Act testing process are abandoned because while they pass the animal testing, they don't pass clinical trials on humans. So why are we testing on humans or on animals? If it works on an animal, it doesn't mean it's going to work on a human, so stop harming animals. Going back to the Dre's Eye and Skin Experiment, PETA said that when looking at data comparing the skin of 65 rabbits to 65 humans, 45% of the classification of chemical irritation based on animals were incorrect. So why are we hurting these animals to prove something is safe when it actually isn't safe for human use? Something needs to be done about the mistreatment of animals, especially when it comes to product testing. There needs to be a solution to the problem. There needs to be a different form of product testing that does not include the use of animals. This is an issue that needs to be solved at the federal level. The FDA is responsible for product safety, and even they have said that they're constantly looking for a different form of testing, but they're still allowing animal testing to occur. So the fact that they are looking but it's not happening doesn't show that they really care. But there are so many products that are cruelty free, so it shows there are ways that products are tested for the safety of human use, but animals aren't involved. The FDA needs to step up, and if they're really looking, they can find a way to stop animal testing. And as a society, myself included, we can start buying cruelty free products and stop buying products that are tested on animals and stop encouraging people to continue this animal abuse. Products need to be safe for humans, But that doesn't mean animals should be used to find that out. Animals have been used for product testing for decades, and animals have been dying in the process, and something needs to be done about the mistreatment of animals. Animals are being mistreated, and it isn't even legally required that animals be used for product testing, so why are we continuing to use them today when there are many different ways that products can be tested? In today's time, people are just buying products based on their popularity, how they look, what they claim to do. But they are being tested on animals, and there are ways to go about testing these products for our safe use for us that doesn't include these animals. Next time you go to buy a product, look in at the fine print and see where your product is really coming from and make sure it's cruelty-free. Thank you.